Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Great tip today sent in by Crystal. Now, Crystal does the videos at YouTube under the user ID LearnAccessByCrystal. Crystal's an MVP in the Access program and sent along this great tip. And when Crystal started telling me about this, I was like, Crystal, we already know this. I've covered it before. Started talking about the text function. So, we have a date over here in column A, and we can pass both the date and a numeric formatting code, and it will format that date as text using the numeric formatting code. So, it's a great way, if you're joining text and a date, to actually have a lot of explicit control. And I'm sure that I've covered this in the podcast before, like 3Ds gives you the day abbreviation, 4Ds spells out the whole day, 4M spells out the whole month. You know, I use these all the time. Even this one is cool if you're doing those Wall Street Journal charts and you just need JFM, the first letter of the month. You can put 5Ms to get the A. You know, it's been around forever, but Crystal's tip is not about text. It's about a function in VBA called format. And format works just like text for all of these codes, but it handles more codes as well. So I'm going to switch over to VBA here, Alt F11. We'll insert a new module, and I'm going to create a function, let's call it VBA text. And we have a value and a format, and I'm going to return VBA text is equal to format instead of text, my value, comma, my format. Notice out here that you can also add additional arguments that tell you whether the first day of the week is Sunday or whatever, and whether the first week of the year is the first week with 4 days or the week that contains January 1st, and other options there. You'll check out Excel. Our VBA help for that. All right, so now let's come back here and we'll enter our new function equal VBA text of this date using that format. And you see for these initial ones, it works exactly the same. But for all of the ones down here, which generally would be considered invalid, it's working. Let's take a look at these. A single letter Q will give you the quarter of the year. So YY is giving me 09. The slash Q is giving me the letter Q, and then the 3 there is coming from that single letter Q, or just slash Q to get the Q and the quarter number, so I can get quarters. That's cool. Long date, medium date, short date. Hey, that's going to return the long date in the local setting of the computer using the internationalization settings. This one is cool. WW gives you the week number, and then W gives you the day within the week. So, this is going to be week 32, day 5. A single Y tells me the number of days this year. So, August 6th is the 218th day, and then 60s is the same as typing long date. So, very cool extension to the text function. Now, you have to put in a 3-line VBA macro to use format, but if you ever needed quarters, certainly a great way to go here to get quarters or week numbers, or even the week within the year. I want to send thanks out to LearnAccessByCrystal for that great tip. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.